What's up, guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to improve your Discord microphone quality on your Windows PC. The complete guide to this tutorial will be listed in the description below. Open up your Discord app and navigate to your voice and video settings. Here, verify that your input device, which is your microphone, is set to the correct device, as well as your audio output device. You have the option to test your microphone when clicking on the Let's Check button below. This will show you if your mic is too loud or too quiet. You can change your microphone input volume with this slider above, as it can sound a bit distorted when setting it to 100% depending on which mic you are using. As your input mode, I prefer to use voice activity, but feel free to use push to talk, which is especially helpful when you have a lot of background noise. All of the next sound settings will be set so that you can get the best mic quality out of Discord. But depending on your PC's performance or network connection, you might want to change some of these along the way. First off, enable the Automatically Determine Input Sensitivity, which is especially helpful for your listeners as they don't have to adjust your incoming volume. In your Advanced Voice Settings, enable Noise Suppression. This will in most cases reduce background noise being transmitted through your mic. In case you are far away from your microphone, or if your voice is quiet, then Discord might have problems picking up your voice and separating it from your background noise. If this is the case, then disable this option for now. Under Voice Processing, enable Echo Cancellation. Leave Noise Reduction disabled, as you can't enable it when Noise Suppression is in use. I prefer to leave the Advanced Voice Activity option disabled, as Discord always transmits my voice using my particular setup. But in case your voice is not being detected by the application, then make sure to enable this option. Enable Automatic Gain Control for the best voice quality, and then we will take a look at your quality of service setting below. This option will prioritize your network connection to Discord, and will ensure that if your network connection starts to get unreliable, it will try to keep your voice connected. I'd suggest disabling this option if you're using a good network connection. Some users have reported that all other applications or games have a much weaker connection after enabling quality of service high packet priority, but this might come down to your network bandwidth. The attenuation option will come down to personal preference. Set the volume decrease of other applications when you speak or when others speak using Discord. Depending on your use case, this can be helpful. To disable this feature, simply turn the volume slider to 0%. Set your audio subsystem to standard. You can use legacy if you notice that some users have trouble hearing you, but you have to restart Discord after making changes to your audio subsystem for the changes to apply. After taking a close look at your Discord voice settings, you might still notice bad microphone quality when using the application. This can be caused by a faulty device, outdated drivers, or your network connection. Ensure yourself that no other application is using your microphone, or can change your microphone sound output, such as voice changers. Next, open up your Windows settings. Here, under System, click on Sound. Under Input, ensure yourself that your microphone volume is not muted. Some microphones work the best when setting their volume to 100%. But I had experiences where this would only distort my voice when using Discord. Play around with the volume until you find the best volume. When selecting your microphone in this list of devices, you have the option to change your format, which should be set to two channels 48,000 Hz or 44,100 Hz, whichever is available to you. Back in your sound settings, you have the option to troubleshoot your input device for common sound problems. This will take a couple of seconds to scan and verify if you have any easily preventable issues with your mic. In case nothing helps you out, then scroll down and select More Sound Settings to open up your sound control panel. In the recording section, make sure that your preferred microphone is set to the default device and disable all other mics in this list of devices. Next, Right-click the mic you wish to use and navigate to its properties. In the Levels tab, make sure that your mic is not muted. In the Advanced section, allow the two exclusive mode options, which will allow Discord to make changes such as adjusting the mic volume. In the General tab, click on Properties. And lastly, in this panel, make sure that the device's driver is up to date in the driver section. You can then proceed to close all of these windows and verify if your mic quality has improved when using Discord. If this is not the case, then you should head back to your Windows settings. Here, in the Windows Update tab, click on Check for Updates or Download and Install Now. This will take a couple of minutes to download the latest driver, and you should then restart your PC in order to install the update. As a last resort, you will have to reinstall Discord, as sometimes your install can be corrupted or otherwise damaged. In your Windows settings, navigate to Apps, and here, click on Installed Apps. You can then proceed to filter this list by all drives and search for Discord. The Discord app should show up. Click on the burger menu on the right-hand side and select Uninstall. After the installation is done, open up your favorite browser and navigate to discord.com. Here, you have the option to download the installer for Windows, macOS, or Linux. While installing the app, you can change the install location to your SSD, which can in turn also prevent issues such as a bad microphone quality. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.